Now we will be discussing the functions and the powers of controller of certifying authority. I hope that my voice is clear to all.
Yes, yes sir.
Okay, thank you. And you can see my screen also.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So during our last lecture, we discussed about certifying authority. The next authority which we will be discussing is the controller of certifying authorities, or many a times it is called as controller under IT Act 2000. So appointment of controller and other officers. So it is the central government which appoints these officers, that is controlling officer, as well as the deputy controllers, assistant controllers, and other officers who are required for maintaining or for monitoring
So we can't hear you.
Yeah, just a moment. Is it okay now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, thank you. So the central government, by notification in the Official Gazette, appoint controller of certifying authorities for the purpose of this act. And may also appoint such number of deputy just a moment yes so in the amendment were all was decided that as controller, so controller should be assist, so these officers shall also be appointed by the central government, who will be helping the controller in completing his duties or responsibilities. So that was inserted in the with the amendment which was done in the year 2008. Next is the controller shall discharge his functions under this act subject to the general control and directions of the central government. So it is the central government which is the appointing authority of the controller. Next one, deputy controller, controller shall perform functions assigned to them by the controller under the general superintendence and control of the controller. So we have seen that controller is supposed to report to directly the central government, whereas the assistant controller or deputy controller, which are also appointed by the central government, they are not supposed to directly report about their working to the central government, but they are supposed to report it to the controller because they are junior to the controller. So controller is considered as their reporting authority. The qualification, experience and terms and conditions of service of controller, deputy controller shall be such as may be prescribed by the central government. So central government will decide about the qualification, about the experience which is required for the position of controller. So any person who meets that qualification and experience criteria, that person shall be eligible for the appointment of controller. So it is to be decided by the central government. The head office and branch office of the controller shall be at such places as the central government may specify, and these may be established at such places as the central government may think fit. So where the head office should be, where the other offices or regional offices should be situated, everything is to be decided by the central government and not by the state government. There shall be a seal of the office of controller. So whatever documents, physical documents will be signed by the controller, or whatever decision the duties hello mohit
yes sir
kya yes, sir. Bar bar matlab mera na ye ho raha hai kyun aise ho raha hai
kya ho raha hai sir
bar bar wo band ho raha hai aur mujhe wapis se screen share karna pad raha hai आप रिकॉर्डिंग ऑन करते हो तब अभी क्या हो रहा है बार बार मैं डिस्कनेक्ट हो रहा हूँ और फिर वापस से हो रहा है कि रिकॉर्डिंग इन प्रोग्रेस स्क्रीन शेयर बार बार बंद हो रहा है
हाँ आपका इंटरनेट का इश्यू है सर उधर इंटरनेट का कनेक्शन है ना इसलिए ब्रेक हो रहा है आपका इसलिए आपका इंटरनेट बंद होने के कारण से आपका लेक्चर में ऑफ हो रहा है बार बार
उधर से तो कुछ नहीं है ना
नहीं सर इधर मैं प्रॉपरली है मेरे होस्ट होने से मेरे को कुछ प्रॉब्लम नहीं होगा मेरे इधर से बंद हो गया तो पूरा लेक्चर ही बंद हो जाएगा
अब बार बार लेक्चर बंद
नहीं नहीं इधर आपका वॉइस चल रहा है स्टूडेंट्स है प्रेजेंट
हो रहा है और बार बार मेरे को शुरू करना पड़ रहा है मेरे इधर तो पूरा दिख रहा है नेटवर्क मेरे इधर अच्छा है
हाँ नेटवर्क
ठीक है
प्रॉब्लम होने से भी होता है सर इसलिए वही ऑफ हो जाता है ऑटोमेटिकली
ठीक है ओके मैं स्टार्ट करता हूँ यस सो नाउ वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट एम आई ऑडिबल टू ऑल
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank
yes, sir.
You. Because of some technical problem, it is getting disconnected very often. So, we are talking about functions of controller. So, what are the functions of controller? First function is
exercising supervision over the activities of certifying authorities. So it is mentioned in the act, the activities or the functions which are to be performed by the certifying authority. Whether the certifying authority is performing the functions or activities as per the rules which are laid down in the law, in the act or not, that is the one of the function, one of the prime function of controller. Certifying public keys of certifying authority. Now we had discussed that when a subscriber or when a person wants to apply for digital signature, that person gets a pair of keys. One is called as private key, which helps the person to make digital signature. The other pair or the other key in the pair is called as public key, which is being used by the other party to check whether the signatures are authentic or not. In the same fashion, the public keys of the certifying authority is to be checked by the controller. Next one, laying down the standards to be maintained by the certifying authority. So what are the standards which are to be maintained? How the records are to be maintained? So all these type of instructions can be given by the controller to the certifying authority, and the certifying authority are expected to follow these instructions. Next down, next point, specifying the qualification and experience which employees of certifying authority should possess. Now the role of certifying authority is to, am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Now the role or function of certifying authority is to issue digital signature certificate. Now if the certifying authority employs, suppose the business of certifying authority is growing and it is not possible for work certifying authority under the act, now that person feels that it is not possible for him to control the business as the business is growing very fast. Finds 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 people who will be assisting him in his work, then that people should be, what their qualification should be, it is to be decided by the controller. It should not happen that a certifying authority is employing people engineering. Type of qualification if are fixed, then the certifying authority has to see to it that whenever he is employing the services of other people, these employees who are being employed under him or by him are should be possessing certain type of qualification which are mentioned in the act and which are being instructed by the controller to them. Next one, specifying the condition subject to which the now the fees which is to be charged for the digital signature certificate, whether it is or it is to be directly, is it, it is to be sent, it is instructed to the printable material and advertisements that may be distributed or used in respect of electronic. It is the function or it is the duty of the controller that he should check the content of material or advertisement which is being published by the certifying authority. And the controller should always check the issuing of digital signature certificate also, whether all the information which is mentioned on the digital signature certificate is correct or not. Next one, signature certificate key.
Sir,
the format of electronic should be same. The content should be same. Only name of the person can vary. Suppose if Mr. Ramesh can be replaced by Mr. Umesh, but the entire content should be same in each and every digital signature certificate.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I think some technical problem are there. Because of that, it is creating some problem. Okay. So once again, we will start.
Next one, specifying the terms and conditions subject to which auditors may be appointed and the remuneration to be paid to them. Now, for checking whether the certifying authorities are following the rules and regulations mentioned under the Act, whether they are keeping the accounts as expected under the Act or not, so their audit can be arranged by the controller. So controller will fix the audit date, and he will be arranging the auditors who will be auditing the entire accounts of the certifying authority. With the help of this audit, the controller will come to know whether the certifying authority is working as per the conditions, as per the rules and regulations which are mentioned in the Act or not. Then what type of remuneration is to be paid to the auditors? Now here, the certifying authority is supposed to pay the remuneration to the auditors. Next one, facilitating the establishment of any electronic system by a certifying authority, either solely or jointly with other certifying authority, and regulation of such system. Now, as many to make the working process easier, some type of modules are introduced, electronic modules. Now, one such module, suppose the college has introduced a module. That module is that you can write the assignments on paper, click the picture, and you can directly upload the assignments on the portal. And once you submit the assignment, the moment you submit the assignment, automatically it gets displayed in the mails which is being sent to the concerned teachers. So this type of module is being made to make the working easier. Now, same type of module, if one certifying authority wants to prepare, which will make his working easier, or if he is planning to have a joint such type of module, that is to be okayed, that is to be checked, and that is to be approved by the controller of certifying authorities. Next one, specifying manners in which certifying authorities shall conduct their dealings with the subscribers. So specifying manners means here, what is made by the subscriber along with the prescribed fees. And as per the act, if the waiting period is say for 7 days, and if one subscriber approaches the certifying authority that it is very urgent for me, I am ready to pay extra than the prescribed fee, please issue me digital signature within a period of 2 days. And after taking that extra amount, apart from the prescribed fees for the issuing of digital signature certificate, if such thing happens with the certifying authority, then again, this is to be recorded by the controller, and strict action can be taken by the controller against that certifying authority. And if proven guilty, the license of certifying authority can be cancelled by the controller. Next one, resolving any conflict of interest. If there is any difference of opinion, or if there is a problem between the certifying authority and the subscriber, then controller is the authority which is supposed to settle those conflicts or settle those differences of opinion. If the subscriber says that he has applied for the digital signature certificate and after so many days he has not still received the certificate, and if the CA certifying authority, he is justifying that whatever information was sent in the application was not correct, that is why I had rejected the application, I had sent the application back to the subscriber and had conveyed the subscriber that certain changes are to be made in the application. So if such type of dispute is there, whereas subscriber is saying that whatever information he has filled is absolutely correct, no need for any change, and the certifying authority is not ready to accept that answer. So there is a conflict, there is a difference of opinion between two people. One is certifying authority and the other one is subscriber who has applied for the digital signature certificate. Now, in such cases, controller is considered as the authority which is going to settle these disputes. Next one, laying down the duties of certifying authorities. Now, do duties of certifying authorities or responsibilities of certifying authorities are to be fixed by the controller. How they should be doing their business, how they should be maintaining the account of their business, how audit will take place. So all such duties are of certifying authority are to be fixed by the controller. Next one, maintaining a database containing the disclosure record of every certifying authority containing such particular as may be specified by regulation, which shall be accessible to the public. Now it is the duty of the controller that he should be keeping a record, maintaining a record of all the certifying authorities, that these many certifying authorities are working under him, and this is their record, and this record should be shared on the website and of website of the controller, or and it should be accessible to the general public. So these were the controller of certifying authority. Now we will talk about license to issue electronic signature. Now under that, subject to the provision of subsection 2, any person may make an application to the controller for the license to issue electronic digital certificate. Now this is related to the issuing of license as certifying authority. He is in possession of the required qualification. He can make an application, and after receiving the application or on verification of application, if the controller thinks fit, then a license can be issued in the name of certifying authority, and later on certifying authority can issue digital signatures to the subscribers. No license shall be issued under subsection 1 unless the application fulfills such requirement with respect to qualification, expertise, manpower, financial resources, and other infrastructure facilities which are necessary to issue electronic signature. Already the financial or the whether he is in possession of the required infrastructure or not. After verifying everything, then the license can be issued to the certifying authority. Then the license should be valid for such period as may be prescribed by the central government, not to be transferable or heritable. This license is non-transferable. Now, if the certifying authority is no more, then his license cannot be inherited by the wife or transferred to his wife or son or daughter. It gets cancelled, but it cannot get transferred. Now, we will move on to the next part, and that is penalties. Penalties means that in case any person makes violation of the rules which are mentioned under the Act, then what sort of penalties can be imposed on these people, that we will be discussing now. Person does anything given below without the permission of the owner or any other person who is in charge of computer system or computer network, he shall be liable to pay damages by way of compensation not exceeding 1 crore rupees to the person so affected, if he. Now please remember, as this particular law is known to be the most the newest law or a very recent law. That is why the fine or the penalties in this law are very hefty in nature when compared to the penalties under other laws. If we talk about various laws under IPC or Indian Penal Code, the penalty is very less. Say 10,000 rupees, 20,000 rupees, or maybe less than that. But when we talk about IT Act, the penalty is very heavy. It is very huge because it is the newest law, as well as to curtail or to prevent any type of offense related to the IT industry or IT. The government has come up with the idea that the penalty should be very heavy. So we have just discussed that 1 crore rupees penalty, not more than 1 crore. So it can be less than 1 crore. It can be 10 lakh, 20 lakh, 30 lakhs also. It is to be decided by the court of law. So up to 1 crore, the person can be fined. Exact amount, it is to be decided by the court of law. So under 4-5 points, first one, accesses or secures access to such computer, computer system or computer network, downloads, copies any data, computer database from computer database or information from such computer, computer system or computer network. So without permission of the owner of the computer, if somebody else is accessing the data of the person and whatever his private data is there, whatever his confidential data is there, if he is trying to copy that confidential data, then the person is liable for a fine of or a penalty of up to 1 crore rupees. Disrupts or causes disruption of any computer or computer network. If he is, say, disrupting the computer system of a person without his or her knowledge. Now, a person who is the owner of computer without his knowledge, if any other person takes the, control of that particular computer and he disrupt the services, then also the person is eligible for this particular penalty. Denies or causes denial of access to any person authorized to access computer, computer system or computer network by any means. The real owner is being denied because the computer system has been disrupted by another person. So he is unable to access his files. Then the person who has made such disruption, that person is eligible, liable for a fine of up to 1 crore rupees. Next one, damages or causes to be damaged any computer system, computer network data, computer database or computer system or computer network. If any damage is being done to a computer system without the knowledge of the owner, again, the person is eligible for this huge fine. Introduces or causes to be introduced any computer virus. Suppose if somebody intentionally is causing or putting some virus in a computer with intention to disrupt or damage the computer system, that person is also liable for this huge fine. Provides any assistance to any person who facilitate the access of the computer
or computer network in contravention of the provisions of this act. Now, whosoever is helping another person to disrupt the computer system of a particular person, that person is also liable for this huge fine. Next one, charges the services availed of by any person to the account of another person by tampering with or manipulating the computer, computer system or computer network. If anyone is manipulating with the financial data, with the accounts of a person without his or her knowledge, again, then the person is liable for 1 lakh fine. Next one. Return of to the controller or certifying authority, he shall be liable to a penalty not exceeding 1,50,000 for each such failure. So any authority, any person who is supposed to furnish the details to the certifying authority or to the controller, if he or she fails to furnish those details, a huge fine of 1,50,000 can be imposed on that particular person. So these are certain penalties which are very huge in nature. So we will stop here. In tomorrow's lecture, we will try to complete our first unit, and then we can. So thank you for joining today's session. Tomorrow again we will be meeting. I'll let you know what the timing will be, and tomorrow we will try to complete this particular unit. Thank you once again. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.